Hello, welcome to another episode of Max Hasn't Brushed Their Hair Because It Hurts Too Much. Today we're going to talk about weird things that hurt when you have fibromyalgia. Having fibro is like having the flu 24/7, just maybe without the coughing and the drippiness. You know when you have the flu and you have the pain, or maybe even a really bad cold, and you're just full body pain, all the joint pain and the aching, and you just want to lie there and not move? That's fibro 24/7. All of the things on this list you will find hurt when you have the flu. So they hurt when having fibro, and they probably hurt with other chronic pain disorders, but I'm talking from fibromyalgia's perspective. So, here we go. Corners on square cut bars of hand soap. Like when you're washing your hands and you just, like, it's like rectangle shapes are the worst, and yeah, that really hurts my hands. Brushing your hair. No matter how smooth my hair is, how much conditioner I put in, how much mask, any product that's designed to make it soft and easy, no, my hair just hurts all the time. Wearing a watch, wearing a bra. Gently brushing over your skin. I talk about this all the time because it does my head in. So arm and then just like gently. That feels like sandpaper. The water hitting your skin in the shower, especially if you have one of those high pressure nozzle things, it's like taking a shower with sandpaper. You'll see a theme here. Leggings and trousers rubbing your legs when you walk. Opening wrinkles, whether it's a can of soda, or if it's, you know, a can of baked beans. Holding a pen. Holding it like that is painful. Holding it like that is slightly less painful, but still painful. So it's taking off the lid, but I lost the lid to this one because I don't use the lids because it hurts. Opening the compartments to my pillbox. And with my new pillbox, when I refill it, I have to open it 21 times. Releasing the pills from the blister packs. Opening anything with a child safe cap. So, I can't even open this one because my hands hurt. There's a lot of hand things in this. Mainly because when my fibro is bad, I don't do anything. I just stay still. And the only thing working is my hands. I just watched it to prove a point. And I failed. Opening, well, anything really. Exfoliating. Holding a book open. Just, that hurts, that hurts. Even with a book this size. Standing up, both the action of getting up and standing still. And then if you have fainting issues like me, the falling down part hurts as well. Certain fabrics. Mostly denim, anything rough and coarse, not a fan. Sitting down hurts. Anywhere for more than about 10 minutes does start to hurt, so you have to move and shuffle and fidget. Using crutches. I have a bruise, well, you can't really see it, but I have a little tiny bruise there. Doesn't hurt at all, ironically. Just from using my crutches, I did not bang myself, I did not catch it on anything, it just bruised. Anything to do with fingernails. My fingernails are a constant source of pain. Opening key rings. That requires a fingernail to get in the little gap. Or peeling stickers off of things. No. Anything involving fingernails, bad. Carrying anything. When I'm holding a plate, my fingers always bend back because I'm mobile. And putting a bag on my shoulder. That really hurts because of all the muscle pain. There's lots of fibro trigger points around this area, and it's pinching, there's friction, it's just not good. Holding cup handles. This is like insult to injury because I drink a lot of coffee and I cannot hold the cups by the handles. I have to kind of hold them like a glass. Pouring the kettle. Another insult to injury. Why does making and drinking my coffee hurt me so much? We will never know. Well, no, we will. It's fibro. Ha! Touching zips. But I don't mean the opening and the closing of the zips. No. I mean literally just touching. like, no, that hurts, especially if they are open zips, they're a lot sharper. And it might hurt non-fibro people, but it hurts me more. A cool breeze. And this isn't just because of cold urticaria. Just sometimes if my fibro is bad and I'm outside, and just a breeze will go past and it will just irritate my skin, so it might blow the hairs on my arm. And then suddenly I'm very aware that I have lots of nerves in my arm, and they are definitely on. Pop studs! If you haven't seen my post on Instagram and my post on Life Allergic to Cold, I got this inhaler case off of Etsy by Sewn With Love. I will put a link in the description because it's amazing, and I haven't actually had to look for my inhaler for like 2 weeks now, so it's just so good. So I recommend. And yeah, pop studs. They hurt. A lot. A lot, a lot. Using a lighter. Ow. I don't know whether it's how hard you have to grip or what, but that, I use a lot of incense, because pagan, so I'm doing this a lot. It hurts, so I'm gonna stop. Sneezing. Sneezing hurts, because it is a full body thing, and I just try not to sneeze if I can. Like, I will fight a sneeze as hard as I can. Anything touching your skin that's like water drops, so if someone gets wet hands and they like flick it at you, or putting on perfume, or if you get caught unaware by a sneeze, if you sneeze all over yourself, the droplets will hurt. Or if you're me and have cold urticaria, they'll cause you a rash too. Cute. Scratching an itch. I mentioned this in Allergy Awareness Week. When my cold urticaria acts up and I get a rash, scratching it is so painful. I mean, the rash itself is painful. Painfully itchy, and then scratching it is just painful. Can't win. Wearing glasses, the bit over the ear, sucks. Wearing earphones or hearing aids. Oh, anything in the ear really hurts, especially when you have the glasses and you have the fog mask as well. If you saw my post on Instagram, yes. But yeah, wearing earphones or hearing aids. Using scissors. It's the same kind of issue as the mug handle. It hurts with the hands. And finally, whatever the fuck is in my clothes that is poking me in the boob right now, it's driving me nuts. Excellent. Don't forget to like this video, drop a comment with weird things that hurt you with your fibromyalgia, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and ring the bell so you get notified every time I post. See ya.